the dressing room. You both know I expect. Keep it clean, break straight away when told. Both you watch your heads in close. Good luck to you both. Touch gloves.
So the biggest Davis v Taylor on television since 1985 in Sheffield. Tonight, the crucible is the Brayhead Arena. Tonight, someone is going to feel ready to take on the world, Alex Arthur.
Yeah, we should have. Like we've said over and over again, the winner of this fight is going to be moving on in massive things.
Will they take time to try and work each other out? Will Davis look for that big shot early? Taylor feels he can outbox Davis, feels he's got too much speed, feels he's got enough power to stop him. Davis, of course, has very different ideas, and he is very awkward.
And you have to recognise straight away Josh Taylor's tactics. He's moving to his own right, he's waiting patiently to counter Davis's jab. Josh Taylor's intentions here are to box smart in the early rounds, find his feet before putting his foot on the gas in the later part of the fight. Very intelligent tactics for Josh Taylor. The only thing is, can he sustain not letting his heart rule his head? He has to sustain his boxing skills.
Fakes there from Taylor. Davis has fought a couple of southpaws, but no one, of course, of this caliber. Body shot there from Taylor. Davis shakes his head dismissively. This is such a charged atmosphere. Old school. Feels like there's so much on the line.
Josh Taylor staying calm and patient, trying to establish his jab. Davis is a very awkward stance, and it's very difficult to land your jab over Davis's orthodox shoulder. It's a very awkward position to be in.
Got very long arms. O'Hara Davis uses them well. Tries to establish things behind that solid left jab and then let the right hand go. Dismissed Derry Matthews in his previous fight. A big signature win. Howard Foster just warning about use of the head. That right from Davis bounced off the gloves of Taylor. Taylor started well, but just a feeling that Davis fighting his way back into it. Blood from the nose of Taylor as well. And is he just getting drawn into a fight here, Taylor?
Well, no, I think he's just trying to establish his own shots nice and early. He can't give anything away in terms of psychology, so he's trying to make a really good start to the first round there.
Shane McGuigan here with Josh Taylor in the corner.
Don't need to force anything. This guy's going to make mistakes.
Yeah. Nice and calm, clear and concise. And the plan, Alex, very clear.
Yeah, just as I said, you know, he has to stay on the outside of O'Hara Davis's left leg. He has to jab over his awkward shoulder and remain patient for a few rounds. Still try and find his way into the fight without leaving himself exposed to anything big.
Taylor keeps moving to his right, then tries to dart in and score points.
Good right hand from Davis.
First time that just felt Davis found his range there and managed to land on Taylor, looking for it again. Right hook there from Davis. Taylor shaking his head and saying it didn't bother me. Deafening noise here in Glasgow.
I really feel Josh Taylor has to be a little bit busier with his jab. He's waiting a little bit too long. even jabbing around O'Hara Davis's left arm area, as long as he can feel the range and the distance, it can be effective with other punches. But unless he starts to touch O'Hara Davis a little bit more, I kind of feel that he's given O'Hara Davis a chance to actually find his feet and get into the fight a little bit more. Look, Josh Taylor to be a little bit busier.
Could certainly feel the weight sitting here at ringside of those O'Hara Davis punches and of that jab. Taylor digging that left to the body.
Those will pay dividends in the later part of the fight.
It's another thing that the McGuigans feel, that the Taylor cat feels. They can hurt Davis to the body. He's never been attacked to the body, not in a sustained fashion. And Josh Taylor, plenty of that from Taylor.
Josh Taylor is a very good body puncher, a very good body puncher.
Walked onto a shot there, though, Taylor. Davis always looking for that right hand. Look for a left uppercut there as well. Left from Taylor. Davis shaking his head. Cat and mouse with real jeopardy involved as well.
He says Josh Taylor's getting a little bit more comfortable now. Touching him with a jab now. That's all he needs to be doing in this early stage. The other shots will come, but they won't come unless he can touch him with that jab off them. O'Hara Davis really awkward and a really unusual stance. Feet really wide apart. Always ready to throw a big shot.
He can look really ungainly, but those who spar with him, those who've been in with him, say he's a nightmare to face, Davis. Left to the body from Taylor, looked close to being low there. Howard Foster was okay with it. Tony Sings in the O'Hara Davis corner. Kevin Mitchell in there as well, helping out. Big team, big prospect. There's some of the action, Alex.
Yeah, I really thought that was a good round for Josh. It landed a really good left uppercut to the body. He was a little bit more dominant with the jab, a little bit busier, just like we wanted to see.
This early battle for supremacy is fascinating. It's every bit as riveting as we felt it might be. I know so many people have been looking forward to this for months since it was made. Standing and trading just for a moment, which certainly falls into Davis's favour.
O'Hara Davis loading up so obviously with that huge right hand. Taylor caught everyone on his glove, but you don't want to be giving this guy any confidence. You want to take his confidence away nice and early. Look, he's setting up that huge right hand. It's so easy to see coming, and with someone of Josh Taylor's abilities and natural class, he can counter these shots quite easily.
Taylor landed there with a left uppercut. Davis fighting back though. Right there from Davis, left from Taylor. Both starting to find their range here. Taylor just that little bit sharper. Slightly quicker to the punch so far.
A little bit more precise at this point, yeah.
Good work though from Davis. Left uppercut, left hook. Yeah, Howard Foster with a little word to O'Hara Davis about use of the head. Taylor blocks those shots from Davis and comes back with a left to the body. Great action here in round three.
Josh Taylor winning in the battle, the trade-offs there. Far sharper hooks, a lot shorter and neater as well. Taylor's in a much better position to trade up close than Davis is. His feet are far too wide apart, therefore he can't load up on short shots.
He's making Davis look really ragged here, and I think that right to the body hurt Davis. He was gulping for air for a moment. Then a right hook from Taylor. This is brilliant from Josh Taylor.
Beautiful stuff. O'Hara Davis is hurt visibly. Visibly hurt.
He looks unsteady on his feet here, Davis.
He still has to be cautious, as Dave Davis is still a huge puncher.
Taylor mustn't get carried away, but how significant will this third round be? Oh, he just ducked out of the way and caught Davis with a combination.
Beautiful movement from Josh Taylor.
Oh, Davis is staggered. Taylor has him in the corner. Davis is down at the end of the third. Bell's gone. The bell's gone. They wanted to carry on, but what a round. What a round from Josh Taylor.
Unbelievable round. He's just stamped his authority on the fight there, Dave. He really has. With a jab, a stiff, solid jab. O'Hara Davis looking outside the ring for some kind of comfort or help, but he was hurt badly there.
He was hurt from the previous shots, wasn't he?
Yeah.
And that stiff right jab just knocked him off balance. Here's Tony Sims. Careful, he's going to come out firing, and that surely is what Taylor will do. But remember, Davis is a big puncher. Big knockout percentage, very heavy-handed, and Taylor hasn't taken that away from it.
Josh looks very comfortable up close now. He looks very comfortable up close.
Doing a touch of the Tyson Fury's there with the hands behind the back. He doesn't want to get too carried away here, Taylor.
No, he doesn't, but he's growing in confidence, and that's due to the fact that he had such a good round. Josh Taylor's found his feet now. He still has to be cautious, take his time, pick his shots just like he's doing. Davis still appears a little wobbly.
Oh, it's a left hook now from Taylor, and that stung Davis as well. He is feeling this, but he fires back with a right of his own that bounced off the glove of Taylor. Those brilliant amateur skills transferring perfectly to the professional game here from Josh Taylor.
That's what makes the big difference. That's what I said in the build-up to this fight. Josh Taylor's amateur pedigree will stand him in such good stead in this fight, and it's proven to be the case here.
Davis swinging in those right hands. How many is he connecting with, though? Barry McGuigan up on the ring apron, practically screaming advice for Josh Taylor. Eddie Earn there as well, as they stand and they train.
This is a very, very intelligent performance from Josh Taylor. He's actually showing all his attributes here. He's boxing so well. He's so comfortable up close. He's making O'Hara Davis miss and look like a novice. Wild swings, he's catching them all. He's timing his counter punches and attacking back straight away.
But he can't afford to get overconfident.
He can't switch off.
Missed with those big uppercuts, Davis, by some distance. Taylor again darting to the side and throwing that big right hook.
Beautiful change of the feet. Shifted 90 degrees left, threw a beautiful right hook. Timing was beautiful. He has to look for angles to find Davis. He's very awkward and ungainly.
Combination to body then head from Taylor with that right. Again, it looked like it staggered Davis. For all Taylor's brilliance so far, though, for all that he's hurt Davis, Lewis is still in there fighting.
Stop getting brave. Stop getting too brave.
Okay? Yeah, they're worried in that Josh Taylor corner that he's just getting too brave, that he's trying to load up on his shots too much. Alex trying to take O'Hara Davis out. That's not the game plan.
That's especially not this early. But still, he's grown in confidence all the time because he's learned that he can hurt Davis, but Davis can't really get off any clean shots on him.
Taylor happy to mix it up close, then bangs the right to the body, almost down on one knee as he threw that shot. Better from Davis, that right hand just snuck through the gloves. He tries some body work of his own.
Josh Taylor really doesn't need to be sitting on the ropes right now. That's better, just turn that front foot and go back on that jab. Use that great head movement and those skills. He doesn't need to be sitting on the ropes.
Taylor felt that Davis hit him low, but Howard Foster says box on. Little bit of success here for Davis. It's sheer volume from him. I'm not sure about the accuracy, but he is powerful and he's trying to swamp Taylor there.
Yeah, Josh needs to get back to his boxing a little bit. If he's going to stand up close, he has to do what he was doing earlier on. Catch those wild swings and counter with short, neat punches and then roll off. It's quite a simple tactic. And I'm sure that Shane will be quite angry at him when he goes back to the corner in this round for letting that kind of advantage that he had slip.
Well, the general feeling pre-fight from those who know was that if they box, it's Taylor's night. If they fight, it could well be Davis's. And this round has been the one that has suited Davis the most so far. Oh, right, oh, huge from shot. Taylor.
Davis,
and Davis's leg stiffened there.
Yeah, they sure have.
Taylor showing that he can fight all right. Davis is breathing heavily in there. He says it didn't hurt him, but it did.
Whoa,
left
huge
hook
shot
again from Taylor. 30 seconds remaining in the fifth, but Davis fighting back now. Davis throwing those shots off balance up. Taylor is so accurate, so punishing.
And so sharp as well. He needs to keep catching and returning, though he can't take too many. Even round the sides and on the gloves, he has to come back. He has to maintain his advantage. That psychological advantage that he now has.
Little cut on the bridge of the nose of Josh Taylor. Digs another left to the body, then a right.
Blowing out his fucking arse. Don't catch and throw threes and fours, catch and throw singles.
Well, yeah. As you can hear, they feel Davis is tiring.
Yeah, we just heard Shane there again say catch and throw singles. You know, it's something that Josh Taylor just has to maintain for the next few rounds. If he's going to stand there, he has to catch and return with a single shot, roll off and get the hands back high.
Taylor comes out strong at the start of the sixth. If Davis can take this into those last few rounds, those championship rounds, Taylor might regret loading up too much, but that's a long, long way away. Davis caught Taylor on the way in there. Good left jab from him, but he hasn't been able to establish that jab at all, O'Hara Davis.
Not at all, and I think it's from the position that he's standing and where he's actually holding his left arm. It's far too obvious to spot a jab coming from where O'Hara Davis is situated. Technically, Josh Taylor is a far, far superior fighter to O'Hara Davis. And that's showing.
Right hook there from Davis. Just wonder if he slowed up a bit here, Davis. taken a lot of punishment. More excellent body work there from Taylor.
Beautiful work for Josh Taylor. Rolling off them short hooks. Exactly what it has to do if he's going to fight up close. He has to roll off those short hooks, catch the wild swings and return with one short shot. He doesn't want to be trading with this guy. Nice, accurate, short, crisp returns.
That blood from the nose of Taylor. Just running a little bit more free here. Taylor's been outstanding so far, but don't think for a second that this is over. Here comes O'Hara Davis.
Good head movement from Josh Taylor. I'd like to see him go back on that sharp jab now. Re-establish control.
What he's done so well so far has been based on excellent boxing, and he needs to use that again to establish things.
Maybe not textbook, typical boxing, but very precise, accurate, intelligent game plan. Great shot for Josh Taylor.
The way he picked those two right hooks to the head there of Davis. Then a right to the body, trying to get it under that left elbow of O'Hara Davis. Oh, Davis responds though with a good uppercut there.
Josh Taylor's been a success for him.
Standing and trading a bit here. It's not territory Taylor needs to be in. Davis loving this.
Ricky Burns is with us then. Ricky, it's a tough fight for O'Hara so far, is it? Let's be honest.
No, do you know what? Josh had a good start. He found his range very early on. O'Hara, he came out, he looked to be forcing the pace. He seems to be loading up with all his shots. He seems to be trying to take Josh out with one shot. Josh is boxing a very good fighter now. In and out of distance, trading when he has to, then getting away. So. Shape up to be a good fight here.
Yeah, absolutely. It's clearly, would you say it's Josh on points at the moment?
Josh slightly ahead. O'Hara looked as if he hurt Josh at the end of that last round there. But again, we're only halfway through, so still time.
Still time indeed. Thank you.
Yeah, it was interesting to hear Ricky Burns say what we said, that Davis hurt Taylor at the end of that sixth round. Davis is talking to him now and taunting him in the ring. It's been all Taylor so far, but is it about to turn into Davis's fight? Good from Howard Foster. Round of applause for that. Just telling them to cut out the chat and get on with it.
Around for Josh Taylor, just having a look. A couple of suggestions. The last round he was maybe tiring a little bit, but I don't think so. I just think that he's made a quieter start to the round, maybe try to reassess things a little bit. Took a couple of shots towards the end of the last round, so.
Really good boxing again there from Taylor at the start of his seventh. Davis again responds. Taylor needs to box and do his work and get out of range, but he almost like he wants a fight. There's been so much bad blood between them. Taylor wants to prove a point as well as win.
He's actually been very successful at standing toe-to-toe. You can be a really good toe-to-toe technical fighter as well, just because you're standing there trading shots with a big puncher. Technically, Josh has been brilliant up close.
Much more snap in Taylor's punches. It feels that way anyway. Davis there was almost just pushing out his punches. Look- looks for that big right again. Oh, he's done it!
Huge shot.
Right hook from Taylor. O'Hara Davis down for the second time.
Fantastic counter punch. Right on the money. Beautiful shot from Taylor.
Speed, feet, timing. Is this his moment? Davis turns his back. Howard Foster stops it. Josh Taylor proves his point. Josh Taylor reaches for the stars with a stoppage that few thought possible. He outboxed him. He's outpunched him. And Josh Taylor with a dramatic win.
Unbelievable. And I think he just shouted to Ricky Burns. Me and you next. Out the ring. Can you imagine Scotland if that fight took place?
What a performance. Certainly felt like he was hurt by Davis in that previous round, but Alex, how he responded.
What a shot. The timing of the punch was absolutely perfect. Punch perfect shot. Massive right hook. O'Hara Davis walked right onto the shot.
Wow. He is very, very special. Remember, a lot of people saw this as a 50-50 fight. And what was Davis doing? There's been a lot of talk in British rings about quitting recently. He turned his back. He almost didn't like the punishment. I'm not sure what went on there. The shot still landed.
Yeah, it should have landed. And Josh Taylor had every right to follow up that attack. Protect yourself at all times. O'Hara Davis didn't look like he was wanting to protect himself. He didn't want to go on. It looks like he quit.
Don't want to throw that word around. But he just seemed to have taken a lot and turn his back and wave it away. Wow. What lies in wait now for Josh Taylor? There was so much tension around this arena and he has proved so many wrong, and he gets the win. Well, let's just confirm that result. There's lots more to come, but let's just confirm things here with Craig as the celebrations continue here in Glasgow.
Ladies and gentlemen, our referee, Howard Foster, will bring together both boxers. As he does so, he would like you to join him in appreciation of both our boxers in the ring. The end comes. 2 minutes, 25 seconds of round number seven, where referee Mr. Foster stops the contest. His opinion, O'Hara Davis in no position to continue. Therefore, the winner, he is still the Commonwealth and the new WBC Silver Super Lightweight Champion, the Tartan Tornado, Josh Taylor.
The Tartan Tornado continues to